Well, some breaking news coming in. The Karnataka government will now take a call on the school's functioning. The state education minister is likely to meet the parents. The primary education minister is also likely to meet the parents on October the 30th. The minister will also meet the education department officials. The minister is also likely to meet the education department officials on October the 29th. This really is, these meetings are really crucial to decide the future course of functioning of the school in question, where a three-year-old girl, remember, was allegedly raped in Bangalore. Well, it will be back to school for students from class 1 to 5th standard in the infamous Bangalore school where a three-year-old was allegedly sexually assaulted. But questions remain on the fate of hundreds of students in nursery classes and 6th and 7th grade. These allegedly illegal classes are being run by the school management without mandatory government clearance. Meanwhile, the Bangalore police achieved a breakthrough in the case with the arrest of one person. Gundappa has been working at the school for the past 2 years. The 45-year-old was taken into police custody after the three-year-old victim recognized him from a photograph. My colleague Pratibha Raman joins me live for more on this story. Pratibha, that crucial piece of news that you have in fact broken to us this morning about all those meetings that are likely to take place and the fact that, you know, the fate of hundreds of students at this point in time hangs in balance. Given the fact that there have been classes that have been running illegally in the school, you know, is perhaps a shutdown on the cards? How does this entire thing pan out now going forward?
Well, in fact, most of these parents you see here have been standing for the last 1 hour trying to see if they can get some sort of a solution, some sort of an answer from the management's point of view. Because what has happened is on Saturday, where there was a meeting that was held between the management as well as these parents, and the commissioner of police had assured that from the safety and security angle, everything remains intact, everything has been checked and cross-checked, and the school is really safe for all the students. So that is the statement made by the commissioner. And now, basing the commissioner's statement, the management has gone ahead to open the school, the authorized classes from 1st to 5th. Now, these parents whose children are studying in other classes feel that this is absolutely not justified, because their children are sitting at home not knowing what is going to be their fate, what is going to be their future, and how can these students go in for classes. There's absolutely no assurance that's given from the management's point of view whether this issue about license is going to be resolved or not. So that is when the education ministry has tried to intervene, and now the entire fate of the school depends on the meeting that will take place on the 29th.
Back well, all eyes on that crucial meeting likely to take place on the 29th. The fate of hundreds of students at this point in time hangs in balance. A lot of ambiguity and absolutely no assurance been given from the school authorities. Pratibha Raman filed this report for us a little while ago. Let's listen in.
The school today reopens for sections 1 to 5, but then parents of students who are studying in other sections are left in a turmoil. They're absolutely confused about the fate of their students. So, can you talk about what is the kind of turmoil that is there in your minds, especially with regards to the school?
Every parents who are assembled here, they're only the one intention that school has to be get restarted. So, as per the system, if I talk, now in Bangalore, the education department people have said, the day before yesterday, they said 90% of schools which have started newly, they don't have a permission. Then also they have started. Then also it's going on. So what we required is, incident is happened, it's happened. So no one give a guarantee in any other school. If I take an admission for a new school, who will give the guarantee that incident will not happen in that premises? So such a way, so what we are requesting to the management, that restart the school.
Another question with regards to safety and security. And also that your child has been studying in other class. Do you feel that this child will be safe in this particular school when the issue is going to be resolved?
No, the issue will be resolved because when you compare with the security, the security is too good. There's no question about security. It has happened. Now they will take, I think, more action on security.
Now, if the documents here, what they provide, is not very satisfactory, will you be taking your child out of the school?
In middle of the year, I don't want to take out my kid here. My intention is what?
No,
everybody should get a document right. And after that, we need to say, this year let it be complete. Next year, we can take action about that. But what will happen, no, your management is not responding from any documents or anything is not, no, nobody is responding that. Even vice chairman, where is he, I don't know only. Is arrested or where is and what is doing or what step is taken. Nothing is, no information for parents.
Absolute no information there from the management, and that is what is irking most of these parents who really do not know what is going to happen to the future of their child. With cameraperson Madhu, Pratibha Raman, Bangalore, Headlines Today.